Once upon a time, there was an emperor who was interested in just one thing in all the world, clothes. Every hour of the day, from the time he got up till he went to bed at night, this emperor changed into a new costume. And woe to the person who didn't have plenty of complimentary things to say about his clothes. One day, for instance, the prime minister came to the emperor's dressing room.
Your Majesty, I've just been going over the budget. The outlay for clothes is impossibly large.
Really? Tell me, Prime Minister, what do you think of the blue embroidery on this waistcoat? Is it too much?
Entirely too much.
What?
It cost 100 florins. I know. I just went over the bills and...
Oh, the cost. What's that? I was talking about how it looked.
Your Majesty, begging your pardon, but it doesn't matter how it looks. It costs...
Doesn't matter? Have you taken leave of your senses? What kind of a Prime Minister are you?
I? Why,
perhaps you'd like to let the Lord Chamberlain try your post for a while.
Your Majesty, you're joking.
If you've lost all interest in matters of the utmost importance...
Your Majesty, I'm only trying to keep you from going bankrupt when I say that embroidery costs too much.
And that's all you have to say about it?
No, of course not. It's very beautiful, Your Majesty.
Ah... And you don't think it makes for too much trimming on this waistcoat?
No, not at all. It looks splendid, Your Majesty. Positively splendid.
And you said something about the cost, I believe.
I wasn't thinking. Whatever it cost, it was worth it, I'm sure.
Good, good. I'm glad to see you taking a more sensible point of view, Prime Minister. After all, I had to have something to liven this velvet. Good heavens, I'm tired of velvet. I'm tired of all the fabrics the tailors have been using lately.
Well, Your Majesty, there are only so many kinds of material. Silk, satin, velvet, brocade. And with a new costume every hour, 10 hours a day.
What's the matter with the weavers in this country anyway?
They work night and day, Your Majesty.
And what do I get? Just more of the same silk, satin, and velvet.
Is His Majesty free?
It's the Lord Chamberlain, sir.
Oh, yes. Well, Lord Chamberlain.
Oh, you look wonderful, Your Majesty. That costume is exquisite, beautiful, magnificent, simply the finest yet. Your Majesty, there is a young girl who insists on seeing you.
The finest yet? You really think so? But I had a velvet suit on at noon, too, you know.
The finest yet. She positively insists, Your Majesty.
Yes, Your Majesty, forgive me, but I must speak with you. I must. It's not for myself. It's for my little brother. Oh, Your Majesty, only your doctors can help him, they say.
Well, now, well, really. Just a minute now.
Yes, indeed. Are you a stranger to our country, girl, to be so unaware of the customary manner of greeting our emperor?
Surely, my girl, you are impressed by the splendid figure he makes in that glorious new costume.
Oh, I'm sorry. I should have remembered, of course, but I was so... Oh, Your Majesty, you are indeed a dazzling sight. It is a beautiful costume.
Well, you think so, do you, girl? That's nice of you. I like opinions from strangers. They're so unprejudiced.
Your Majesty, may I tell you about my little brother? He's the dearest, sweetest little fellow. Oh, Your Majesty, please say I may bring him to your doctors.
2 o'clock. Good heavens, 2 o'clock already. It's time to change.
But Your Majesty...
Run along, girl. Run along, Prime Minister. Lord Chamberlain, the new purple robes, I think. Oh, dear, but they're velvet, too. Oh, why doesn't someone weave a brand new fabric?
Your Majesty, I weave a little.
Something brand new and rich and... What's that? You weave, girl?
Yes, I can do very fine patterns and designs. I would be glad to weave for you if...
You weave? Well, why didn't you say so in the beginning? Have the Prime Minister get you anything you want. You can work right here in a room in the castle if you want.
And my little brother? You'll let your doctors attend him? Cure him?
Yes, of course. Take care of all the details, Prime Minister.
Yes, Your Majesty.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
Never mind that. Weave me something new and different. Get busy at once. Today. Now, Lord Chamberlain, those purple robes.
Now, Dickie, just let me wrap this cloak about you. So you'll be all ready when the carriage comes from the castle. You're not too weak to sit up?
No, no, of course not, Grisel. Oh, Grisel, I'm so excited. The Emperor must be a very nice man.
Well, his doctors will be able to make you well again, Dickie. I know it.
Then why do you still look so worried, Grisel?
Oh, Dickie, I had to get the Emperor's consent, and I wasn't really telling a lie. I can weave a little.
I don't understand what you're talking about, Grisel.
Oh, never mind. There's the carriage, just as the Prime Minister promised. Oh, we're going to the castle, Dickie, and the doctors will take care of you and make you well. And that's all that matters. Oh, dear. Another mistake. Oh, what will I do?
Well, well. And how's the weaving coming along, my girl?
Oh, Your Majesty, good morning. Oh, you look very splendid this morning.
Oh, you think so? Just another red satin outfit. It's your work here. I'm anxious to see what's taking shape in that loom. Well?
Your Majesty, I'm really only getting started. You mustn't judge by this.
Well, no, I guess not.
Your Majesty, if you'll just give me a little more time, it will get better. Yesterday, your doctors examined my little brother. They gave him some medicine and prescribed treatment. Already he's better, Your Majesty.
Yes, well, I'm glad to hear that. But see here...
I can't thank you enough for letting me bring him here to the castle. And he thanks you, too, with all his heart.
He does, eh? You're an odd sort of girl, I must say. Always talking about your little brother. Don't you care about fine clothes, beautiful materials, rich embroidery?
Well, really, Your Majesty, I think a good and honest person could wear rags and look beautiful.
What? Oh, that's nonsense. That's...
Oh, here you are, Your Majesty. I've been looking all over the castle for
Well, me. Lord Chamberlain?
Oh, you look marvelous, magnificent, splendid. Oh, your 10 o'clock outfit is definitely the finest yet, sire. Your Majesty, two mysterious strangers are most anxious to see you at once.
Two mysterious strangers? What's so mysterious about them?
Your Majesty, they say they are weavers.
Weavers?
But not just ordinary weavers, Your Majesty, at least not according to them. They said to tell you they're magical weavers.
Magical weavers? Oh, what can that mean? Oh, I must go interview them at once.
Yes, I thought you'd want to see them immediately.
I do, indeed I do. After the disappointment of this girl's efforts so far, magical weavers are just what I need.
Yes, Your Majesty, we weave...
The most beautiful fabric ever seen on Earth.
It shimmers like the sun.
Glows like the sea.
My, it sounds like just the fabric I've been dreaming of, if it's really as wonderful as you say.
Your Majesty, it's even more wonderful than we've said.
Yes, wait till you hear.
When we said we were magic weavers, well, this fabric we weave...
is not only beautiful beyond words, it has a magic power that will really amaze you, Your Majesty.
A magic power? The cloth itself?
Yes, Your Majesty. Only those folk who are honest and worthy of the post they hold can see this gorgeous cloth.
To everyone unworthy of the job he holds, the cloth is invisible.
Oh, what? Do you mean it?
Mean it? Look, sire, by this 7-pointed star I wear o'er my heart, I swear it is so.
And think what it will mean. Have you ever had doubts about some of your advisors? Your Prime Minister, for instance, ever wondered if he had your best interests at heart?
Oh, I have wondered. Indeed, I have.
Wait, only wait till the cloth is woven. If he sees it, all is well. But if he doesn't...
Oh! How soon can you begin work? How soon?
Well, we need looms, Your Majesty, and money for the finest gold and silver thread.
Much money, sire, but...
The cloth will be worth it.
Yes, anything you want, anything!
A secret place to work?
Of course, the loft beyond the room where the girl is with her little brother. Come, come, and perhaps you can have a costume of this wonderful new material ready for my birthday parade.
Oh, Feeny, did you ever dream he'd go for it so completely?
No. Oh, by the seven-pointed star I sewed on my waistcoat, I never dreamed it would be this easy.
All we have to do from now on is eat, sleep, play cards,
and sit up at these looms and pretend to weave when anybody comes by.
Eat, sleep, pretend to weave, and collect money.
Oh, right, yeah, let's not forget the main part of our project, getting all the gold we can out of the old fool.
Ah, Feeny, my boy, there never was such a beautiful swindle. We'll both wind up rich as
Graysell, wait, Graysell, what's the matter? Why did you come running in like that?
I heard it all, Dickie. I never meant to listen at first, but then I heard what they were saying. I heard them laughing.
Graysell, what are you talking about?
Those new weavers up in the great front loft. They're not magicians. They're swindlers.
What?
Oh, with your good, honest little heart, you'd never understand, Dickie. But the Emperor's giving them thousands of florins, and they're just out to cheat him. Oh, I've got to tell him. I've got to tell him right away. Your Majesty, you must believe me.
Believe you, eh?
Yes, after I heard them talking, I got a chance later to look at their looms. And even though they were pretending to weave, there wasn't a thing on the looms.
Oh, that's good. That's great. Now I know they're really first-rate magicians.
Your Majesty, how can you say that?
Oh, my dear girl, those weavers told me anybody who is unfit for his or her job will find the cloth they weave invisible. Well, you're a very nice girl, but you took on a job of weaving when you came to the castle, and you certainly aren't very good at the job.
Oh, Your Majesty.
Yes, yes, I saw that for myself. So now, when you tell me you can't see that magical cloth, it just proves what those weavers said.
Oh, what can I do now?
Don't worry. I won't send you packing, even though you are a poor weaver. Stay on till your little brother is completely well.
Oh.
But, oh, I can hardly wait now till those weavers send me word to come look at the cloth. It must be gorgeous, magnificent. Oh, wait till I have an outfit made of that. Oh, I can hardly wait. I can hardly wait. I can hardly... Naturally, there isn't the slightest doubt about my being able to see the cloth. However... Prime Minister, I have had word from the weavers that they are coming along very nicely with that magical cloth they are weaving for me.
They should be. Do you know how many thousand florins I've given them for thread so far? 12,569.
Never mind that. If it's all they say, it will be worth it. And that's why I called for you, Prime Minister. I want you to go have a look at what they've done so far.
Me?
Why, yes. Why not? Are you by any chance afraid to go look, Prime Minister?
No, of course not, Your
well,
Majesty.
Well, then, go this morning. Go at once. I shall be waiting to hear what you say.
florins so far, Feeny.
For just sitting around up here and sleeping.
Think we can ask for another 1,000 florins today?
Why not? We need bales of pure golden thread for this material, after all.
Oh, yeah. And another 1,000 florins tomorrow, and more the next day. Oh, it's a wonderful life, if you're clever.
Hark, someone knocks.
Quick, to our looms. Pretend to weave.
I see you in there.
Come in, come in.
Oh, Prime Minister, good day to you, sir.
Yes, yes, good day. You'll excuse us if we continue to weave, sir. We're most anxious to have this material finished by the Emperor's birthday.
Yes, of course. I came at the Emperor's request to look at the cloth and report.
Well, what do you think, Prime Minister? Ever see anything like that before?
Where?
Prime Minister, don't tell me. Oh, Feeny, and I thought for sure he'd be able to see it. An excellent Prime Minister, I thought.
Yes, yes, I too. Oh, but this magic never fails. Obviously, he isn't...
Stop that crazy talk at once. I see the cloth. Certainly I see it.
You do?
Of course, it's beautiful.
You really think so? You like this border at the edge, do you?
The border. Oh, yes. Yes, it's fine.
Good. Then you'll tell His Majesty you're well, please.
Oh, yes. And you'll be finished, when?
Well, looking at it, when would you figure, Prime Minister?
Looking at it? Looking at it. Will it be finished in time for His Majesty's birthday parade?
Well, if we get right back to work. Come on.
Yes, I guess you can promise it for his birthday, Prime Minister.
Your Majesty, day after tomorrow is your birthday, and you still haven't gone to see the material the weavers are creating for you. Aren't you curious at all?
Curious? Of course I'm curious. You saw the material, Prime Minister? Saw it clearly?
Yes, Your Majesty. I know I'm a good Prime Minister and worthy of my job, so of course I saw it.
Surely I'm as worthy to be Emperor as you are to be Prime Minister.
What's that, Your Majesty?
Nothing. I just want to wait till it's finished, that's all.
Your Majesty, the material is finished.
Oh, yes, Lord Chamberlain. What?
Yes, Your Majesty. The weavers would like you to come now to be fitted for your robes for the parade.
Come to be fitted?
I guess the moment has come when you have to go look at it, Your Majesty.
Have to? What kind of talk is that? This is the moment I've been waiting for. Come, I know it's going to be splendid.
There you are, Your Majesty. Does it please you?
Yes, is it all you'd hoped, Your Majesty?
I think it's magnificent myself, but then it's up to you, Your Majesty.
It's up to me now, isn't it?
Only feel that texture, Your Majesty.
Feel it? Yes, feel it.
Oh, not there, sire. What's the matter? Can't you see?
Yes, of course I can see it. It's gorgeous, magnificent. Drape it over me at once and begin the fitting.
Yes, of course, sire. Just a minute now. There.
Feels like nothing, doesn't
it? Nothing? Yes, it certainly does.
Fine as a spider's web. Oh, yes, indeed. The stuff dreams are made of.
Yes, indeed. Dreams. That is, it's...
What a sight you'll be in the parade on your birthday.
Yes. A gorgeous fabric like this. Why, I'll be a sensation.
Merciful saints, I never saw such a crowd lined up and waiting for the royal procession.
You know why, don't you, Master Gregory? You heard what they're saying about the material the Emperor's robe is made of.
Sure, I heard. Only upright and honest people can see it, they say. Wonder how many of us in this crowd will see it.
Make way now. Make way.
But, Lord Chamberlain, I told you I don't want to see the parade.
I do, Graysell. My goodness, I wouldn't miss it for anything.
Besides, it's the Emperor's orders. Everybody in the castle turns out. I'm due over near the gates now.
Oh, I'm so excited.
It's because you don't know, Dickie. Oh, poor silly man.
What's that you're saying, miss? Who's a poor silly man?
Oh, but it's his own fault. I won't care.
The parade's beginning!
Yes, yes, it's beginning!
Can you see the Emperor yet?
I can see the royal canopy that shades him.
Listen, they're admiring his new clothes.
No, he's coming in sight. He's... Why, her!
Can you see his new... Oh.
But, sister, the Emperor hasn't any clothes on, just his underwear.
Dickie,
he hasn't any fancy clothes on at all.
Who said that? Who spoke?
I did, Your Majesty, sir. And why didn't anybody else tell you? They should have.
Listen to the innocent. And he's right. I'll admit it. I don't see any new clothes on the Emperor either.
No lie! It's true!
Silence! The child who spoke out, let him come forward.
Oh, Dickie, what have you done?
Why, told the truth, that's all. Come, Graysell, come with me.
Of course, Dickie. Your Majesty, please don't punish him.
Why, it's you, the girl who said she could weave, and it was your little brother who spoke out.
Yes, Your Majesty, I spoke. I had to.
Had to? Those weavers said only dishonest people would find the material invisible. But can a little child like you be dishonest?
I'm not telling a lie, Your Majesty. You've been very kind to me. Your doctors helped me get well, so it seemed like I ought to tell you. You weren't dressed right for a parade.
I thought I couldn't see the cloth because I wasn't a good emperor.
You couldn't see it because there wasn't any. Those weavers weren't magicians. They were swindlers. I tried to tell you.
And now here I stand before all my people looking like a fool. A poor, half-naked fool. Listen! They're laughing!
Your Majesty, my mother taught us the only way to face the world after making a terrible mistake was to admit the fault.
Admit it? Yes! My people, I don't blame you for laughing. I stand here looking like a fool, and I am a fool. I haven't any fine clothes on. I've been cheated and swindled by my own vanity.
Your Majesty, look! Look what's happened!
What's that?
You do have clothes on. All of a sudden, you have robes on of pure gold.
Robes of gold? Is it true? It looks like it, but I
guess there is magic in the world, Your Majesty. Magic the weavers never dreamed of. When you began to speak in honesty and humbleness, the golden robes appeared.
Now I'm dressed in gold. But that isn't why I feel better than I ever felt in my life.
I imagine you feel good for speaking the truth.
Yes, yes! My people, will you forgive my past vanity and have patience as I endeavor to be a better ruler to you than ever before in the past? Thank you, thank you. Then the parade will continue. But Prime Minister!
Yes, Your Majesty.
Another horse for this little boy and his sister. Let those who first spoke out the truth lead the way.
Long live the Emperor!